you doing, guys?
Good. Hey, how you doing?
Good, good.
Anthony, beat Zach Ziegler.
Zach, what's happening, brother?
How you doing?
Good, good. Thanks for doing this.
No, thank you. Look, this is obviously a lot of craziness happening right now. And, you know, Don and I were talking about how, you know, trainers that are coaches that are not really sure what to do right now, now would be the time to make this push into digital, or else you're going to get really kind of left in the dust. And he immediately said, I got a guy. I know somebody.
Yeah, Don was fired up yesterday, man. I just was texting him to check in, like, hey, Don, like, just checking in on you. Hope you and your family is doing great. And then he texts me a couple of times, and all of a sudden the phone's ringing, and then he's, like, fired up. And I was like, damn.
Yeah, you know what, dude? Because, Anthony, you and I mean, I'm not saying we've been predicting this is going to happen, but people just don't know how to, one, market themselves, and two, they're killing themselves session by session. And that's why I wanted to talk to you.
Can we pick that apart then? And maybe, Anthony, you could help you could help out here with your insight because, you know, where do you start? So say someone that is used to just being a coach now has to figure out how to reinvent themselves in a way if they've never done anything in this space. So what's the first step? What do you do?
Get off Netflix, all right? You know, the bottom line is here, Zach, I mean, right now I'm seeing a lot of people like, okay, the gyms are closing. I got a lot of time, blah, 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 complaining. Not, you know, and there are so many people offering things right now. I can tell you right now at strengthcoach.com, what we tried to do is like, what can we do to help to give people an opportunity to come on the site? So instead of $1 for 3 days, we went $1 for 30 days, okay? To give people an opportunity to come on. We had like 200 signups. So that's obviously keeping from 26 countries around the world. Now we're trying to keep up with that. We're trying to provide resources for people, but other people are doing that as well. And there's so many resources. For example, Patrick Beath and Pat Rigby have a product called Rapid Product Creation, and they're offering it for free right now. Pat Flynn has a book called Let Go. When he was fired from a job in 2008, the Kindle edition is free. Will It Fly? If you have an idea, that's Pat Flynn's book on Will It Fly in the Market. Here's a way to do it. But he's offering that for free, a Smart From Scratch online course. There's so many things out there right now that you can do. And, you know, without either paying any money or just paying a little bit of money or invest in yourself right now, but spend that time. I've been up till 12 o'clock, 1 o'clock in the morning, some of these nights, just trying to get, you know, we try to send everybody an email. I'm trying to provide these resources, trying to stay up to date with the forum. We started a special, you know, COVID-19 forum, a special COVID-19 resource page. We're trying to provide all those resources. So do what you can all the time. Get off Netflix. I mean, it was a joke, but at the same time, like, I don't want to see you on like, oh, you know, I'm binge watching this or that. No, now is the time to learn because you, and Don and I said this yesterday, we don't want to be like, hey, we told you so. Right. But Train Heroic has been my sponsor on the Strength Coach podcast for about a year and a half. And part of my pitch with them is, guys, if you're not doing this online thing at this point, you're behind the curve. You got to get with it. They got a free 2-week trial. If you decide to say blah, 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 they have a great ramp up. The bottom line is, okay, if you didn't take action, that's the past. Let's go. Here's your opportunity. I even made a video yesterday of how to make a video really quick with your phone and the YouTube app. It took me 5 minutes. It's a 5-minute video just because people are like, oh, I don't have an exercise library. Well, get to work then. You can make your exercise library.
Yeah. I shot behind me last night alone. I came in and I shot in an hour. I think I shot 40. I had to shoot 40 movements. Use your time wisely. Like this is, we're stuck at home. I understand. I was laughing. I was able to watch in the last 10, 12 days since being off, I think one movie. Time right now to put our foot down and to try and offer value to people's lives.
Yeah, I don't think what you're saying is, you know, burn yourself out. You're saying invest in yourself, put all the time in, and don't spend the majority of your time wasting this opportunity to better yourselves and better your position. Yeah, it may be a setback at the moment, but, you know, what you guys are saying is make it work for you. Find a way to make it work.
Actually, no, I almost disagree. I'm almost saying burn yourself out right now. Yeah. When are you ever going to have that opportunity where you technically don't have to wake up by an alarm clock? You can get to bed at a reasonable hour. You're not going to any bars. Like, you can control. You're in a controlled environment right now for the next month, 6 weeks of your life. And my thought process is put your foot down on the gas pedal. Burning yourself out, that's a long-term thing. We're home right now. We have this opportunity to go and to put our head down into our computer and our books and create something. Take advantage of it.
All right, well, our situations are different. I have young kids. My kids aren't grown, so that's my priority. Yes. My wife is going insane because my 15-month-old daughter is up her ass all day long, and it's wearing on her. So I have to do my best to utilize and maximize my productivity. If you're doing the best you can do to take that next step forward, even if you've been forced to take that step back, that's the best that you can offer. And I believe I'm doing that. I think, you know, I would love when you said, oh, you know, all the time that I get jealous when you're like, oh, this is all I've been doing, man. I got to be honest. I am like, I wish I could do that. But no, I do know what you mean. I think it's, you know, for a lot of the people that you said are just kind of like, oh, well, I'll just, this is a vacation. Like, I don't view it as that at all. I'm viewing it as this is the time to be productive because yeah, at the end of the day, there are the people that love to train and want to know more. Right now they're looking for places to go. And that's why it's really great that you're reaching out and finding new ways to get to your audience. And I know Don is doing the same. He's helped Muscle and Fitness a lot and just trying to get out there. And we're, you know, we want to get these voices out. So it's been great for us. And we've been able to meet a lot of people too in the process.
Absolutely. It's kind of why I wore this shirt on purpose just after Don's rant yesterday. Like Don was getting pissed, and I said, yeah, you know what? He's right. Embrace the suck right now because, you know what? Dive in. There's plenty of resources for us.
What was Don pissed about? What was he angry about? Don, is it okay if he tells?
I think, you know what? It's funny. I did a lecture at Perform Better, and I just got back from California, the Results Fitness University Mastermind. He did the keynote there. And I wrote a book called Be Like the Best, and in that book, I interviewed people on success. Don was one of them. He's one of the first people I thought of. And so in the lecture, I actually have a picture of Don with a shirt off that says success is about consistency, right? And the reason why I put the shirt off picture was there, I actually wanted to make a point. I did it on purpose because I said, you don't get a body like that based on not being consistent, but never mind that. That's not what I'm talking about with Don here. What I'm talking about is a guy, go on Instagram, watch this guy. He's an animal on Instagram. You will get exhausted watching this guy, the amount of work that he does. So that's really where Don was coming from, was like, look, I'm sitting here. This shit didn't come easy for Don. He works his ass off with this stuff. And that's the point, is like, all of a sudden people are like calling him like, hey Don, let's do this together. Yeah. Like, you know, now that they don't have anything and they didn't prepare. Again, not that I'm saying I told you so. Yeah. Don's been doing his lecture and Perform Better about social media, saying you got to get with this. You got to do this. Here's the system. I laid it out for you. I've been saying on Strength Coach Podcast, hey, train heroic, guys. If you're not on this, you're behind the curve. Get with it now, because this is what's going to happen. You got to diversify your portfolio. So I think his anger was more like, guys, come on. I've been telling you this, and now you're coming here saying, hey, what do I do? No, that's just bullshit.
Yeah, yeah. It's sometimes these situations, I mean, but I think my anger more comes down to the fact that people just want to be saved, and there's got to be some accountability here. Everyone's just looking at this person up on a pedestal saying, oh, you know what? He's making millions of dollars and he's successful and he's on TV and he's doing great. But like, shit, they never actually saw the bumps and bruises. And that's what bothers me. Every 23-year-old coach who's like, I don't know what to do. And I'm like, what are you talking about? You're doing it.
Right.
Like, stop saying you don't know what to do. You're doing it. You're in your profession. Fuck up. Make mistakes. Learn from it. And just let time steer the course.
So in a sense, it's kind of like training, in the sense that one method isn't going to work for everybody, right? So you have to find your own. So just because it worked for a Gary Vee or a Howard Stern or a Don Saladino, it doesn't necessarily mean it's going to work for you. But if you see the mistakes that those people made and you see what they did to succeed, you could use that in your own, in what you're doing to build toward your own success, right? Because that's kind of like what you're saying, that they're not actively learning. They're kind of just wanting to be told and led like a lemming rather than be an active learner and be a sponge and take that and apply it.
Anthony, what were you doing 15 years ago? And I'm not jumping topics here. This has got to do with what you just asked. All
right. Yeah, so before I was in this, I was in the bar business.
Okay.
So, right?
You were in the bar.
It was my first year in the fitness business.
All right. So you were in the bar business, and now you're working for one of the biggest strength and conditioning names in fitness, and you're basically steering their online platform. You're working with the Babe Ruth of strength and conditioning, basically. I mean, holy shit. Like if someone told you that 15 years ago, you'd be like, what are you talking about?
Yeah, and I was doing that 5 years in. So like, yeah. Because I pushed it, you know, because I was working all the time. I was focusing on that. I was thinking of, I was trying new things. I asked the questions. I, you know, asked for those partnerships. I did the work, you know, that's what you were talking about earlier when you were talking about mistakes, like looking at those mistakes. It's this idea of ready, fire, aim. Like people are saying, that's why I made that video about, hey, you know, stop complaining. Here's the way to make a exercise video on your phone with the YouTube app really quick, because you're making excuses. Stop making excuses, because it's all right here. And people want to jump, basically what Don was saying is they want to jump to their dessert before they get to their appetizer and their meal. And they just want the dessert. And that's the problem, is they don't want to put that time in, number one. But I think another problem is people are trying to think, okay, this shit happened. Now what do I do? I got to go online and start marketing. No, you got to first take care of the clients that you have now. That's start there. And you don't need to be on all these fancy platforms. You can just film the videos, send them a PDF. That's how you start. You just got to get started.
So it seems to me that, and I'm not putting words in your mouth, I'm not trying to, but what to avoid seems to be overthinking things. But you want to have your plan and you want to take care of who you got, but you have to, you've got to go for it, and you've got to be okay with embracing that failure. As you say, embrace the suck. You've got to just be all right with not every hit being a home run.
You really do. I like that saying, and I put it in my book. It's, good man learns from his mistakes, a better man learns from other people's mistakes, but the best man learns from other people's successes. So by looking at all of those, you know, you have your own mistakes, you have other people, you know, you're learning. Success leaves clues. So look at the way, what is Don doing? If you don't want to buy a course or whatever, go on Don's Instagram, just follow him, study him. Don did that actually in his lecture, did a case study of like 4 or 5 really good Instagram, like high followers, and kind of say, look, this is what they're doing. This is what they're doing. You could do that on your own.
Right. I like what you just said though, about going after your own clients. And like, that's the lowest hanging fruit. And that's something that I'm seeing right now. And I saw it through some of my coach. Like I had a Zoom call with all my coaches yesterday, and I have individual coaching calls set up with them right after this. People just start focusing on a lot of the wrong stuff. Where the first thing they should be doing, a lot of these coaches, are stroking relationships, having conversations with their clients. How you doing? Are you all right? How's training? Yeah, you know what? I'm not training right now. Listen, you know what I'm going to do? I'm going to send you 3 movements. I want you to do those 3 movements. How to, you know, send the 3 movements. Don't worry about it. I got you. You send them the 3 movements. Put it on your social, but send them the 3 movements. And then the next thing you know, you do a follow-up. How to go, I actually really liked it. You know what? We could do a FaceTime call. Oh, you know, I'm not really sure. Listen, do me a favor. 30 minutes is on me. Instead of watching that Netflix movie, why don't you come do 30 minutes of training with me and let's see how you feel. Because guess what? This is when coaches need you the most.
Can't watch a movie in 30 minutes, Don.
Nah. Sure. But you follow what I'm saying.
Now. I get it. I know what you mean. I was just busting your chops.
You had that time anyway.
Right.
So give it away to a client. Pad that relationship. Allow them to build some consistency and some trust now that doing this, over the computer, I can still get a good training session in, and then start building your digital client base. That's how it needs to be done, but no one wants to do it.
I think that's something you just hit on, is trust, is that instead of trying to go for like the, I don't know, as you said, just puking stuff out there, hoping that it, you know, somebody responds to it. It's, you know, building that trust, and also, you know, getting people to understand that you're, you know, just what we've talked about too, you know, we're trying to relate to people, trying to see really what they're going through and trying to find different ways to reach them with it. Like, look, I could turn on the news right now and I know things are pretty bad. They're pretty fucking horrible. And I hate the fact that there's people being sick, and, but I'm doing, I was asked to stay home. That's okay. I could do that. I could do that. So people are worried about their careers, their jobs. What do they do? And I think, you know, what both of you guys are doing is saying, exactly what needs to be said by everybody in this position is be proactive, get out there, start to do this.
Yeah. And, you know, like, just to kind of go deeper onto this low hanging fruit idea and like understanding about your client is, when I was in the bar business, I have this saying, like, don't worry about the people on the line. Okay. So I worked for, you know, Celebrity in New York City and all these different bars, and everybody always wanted to be there. So at some point the place would become really crowded. So I would go up to security. I said, don't let anybody in right now. And I would walk around. Can I move around? That's number one. Am I moving around comfortable? How's the temperature? How's the music level? Can people hear it? Good. Let me look at my bartenders. Can they serve drinks? Are the waitresses standing around talking to each other? Or are they in the weeds? No, everybody's fine. Good. Security, give me five people. Good. They come in. They're like, Aunt, we got a line. I don't care about the line. Those people are not my customers. The, right. The people that are my customers, the low-hanging fruit, are in the bar right now. And I think people tend to worry about marketing all the time. Like, wait, first of all, worry about retention right now. If you have X amount of clients, worry about those people. And to Don's point earlier, like when you're talking to your people, sometimes don't put them in your box all the time, because we don't, this is a totally different situation. Somebody's home. Zach's home now. He has a totally different schedule. So, you know, meet Zach. He is. So don't be like, hey, here's your workout.
Yeah.
Where you normally did at 6. Wait, Zach's got Olive and he's got to worry about her. And he's got a totally different schedule. We got to meet Zach. And you're not going to find that out by worrying about the people on the line. You're going to find that out by worrying about the people inside the bar, what's happening with them, what's going on. Do they have Olive to take care of, right?
That's a good point about just finding ways to adapt to a client, and rather than thinking the client's going to adapt to you.
Especially right now. This is right. This is crazy what's happening.
Yeah. Well, I think that's a big problem with trainers building their client book. I mean, early on when you were training people, when I was training people, you had that level of hunger in you where it was like any person that wanted to train at any hour. It was like 10 p.m. All right, hold on. I know we're not open at that time. Let me talk to the gym owner at the training ground and I'll try and open the doors. And the reason why I got frustrated yesterday is that coaches, you've asked for this. You wanted the opportunity to go digital. And you've said to us this a million times, Ann, I don't have the time. Now you have the time. So go get it. That's all I'm saying.
So Don, the frustration wasn't about people hitting you up, wanting you to do free stuff for them. Was it people seeking advice from you that you've already given advice to? So I'm trying to just kind of nail that down.
I think Anthony was probably right a little bit. I never mind when someone continually, when people ask the same question over and over, I get it. It's not what they do. It'd be like me calling my financial advisor, asking him, questions over and over and over. He's there to hold my hand and to guide me.
Yeah.
I totally get it. But I almost feel like it's like the client that keeps asking you the same question over and over, and you keep giving them the same answer,
right,
but they're expecting it to be different. You know what I'm talking about?
They're eating a bag of Doritos as soon as they leave your session and saying, why, Don, your program's not working. You know,
can't lose weight.
I had one of my favorite clients ever, not a celebrity, one of my favorite human beings. I'll never forget this, a year ago. And this guy is crazy successful. He turned to me and he's like, this is ridiculous. Why do I keep gaining weight? And I'm like, well, let's look in the last month. How many times have you been here? I don't know. I go, you've been here twice. I said, and you're out eating, you know, pasta every night and you're having a couple of drinks every night. So what do you expect? And like a little child, I don't mind saying this, he literally almost started kicking and screaming. He goes, this is ridiculous. I should be able to go out and have a meal and exercise and I should be able to be fine. And I looked at him. I was like, do you want a tissue? You want to go in the bathroom and start crying? Because that's not how it works.
You said that to a client?
Yeah, of course I did. This is how I talked to them. I'm sorry you get everything you want in life. This is what I said to him. I said, I'm sorry you get everything you want in life and everyone's kissing your ass. This is the one thing you're not going to get. This is the one thing. This is the one thing you can't buy.
Right.
It's like the rules are not going to change. There is not going to be a fucking exercise machine that's going to suddenly fix it. There's not going to be a pill that you take that suddenly fixes it. The squat hasn't changed. The bench press hasn't changed. Running really hasn't changed. Like, this is just how it is. And yeah. That's what I get pissed off about.
Well, there's no shortcuts. I mean, it's either want it or you don't. And it's like, you know, it's kind of exactly what we've been saying this whole time. Sometimes it kind of sucks and you got to embrace it. It sucks in the sense that it takes you away from what you normally do. So it can be tough. Like, so yeah, if you're eating those Doritos every day after you leave your session and then all of a sudden you're not, yeah, that might suck a little bit, but you know what, if you have that goal and you want it, then you know what, then that's the way to get there and just shut up and do it.
The thing that's driving me nuts is people are turning to me going, no, I'm just trying to maintain. I'm just trying to get by. Why don't we focus on getting better right now? Because we have 4 weeks, 8 weeks, 12 weeks where we're going to be in this environment. Why don't we get on a program? Why don't we go find a coach that can actually help us improve our current condition with a pair of tomato cans or two water bottles? Or how about this? Just an open floor that's on the ground.
Yeah. Because
that can be done. That's called coaching.
Yeah. No, I love it when you're shot out of a cannon, first of all. Yeah. I think it's great when you get fired up. I love it. But you're right. I think it's also like it's reminded me a little bit of how spoiled I've gotten. I don't need all the bells and whistles. I do have some equipment here. But, you know, even recently, just because there's been a lot of body weight stuff going around, I know Don's done a bunch of it. I'm like, you know what? Let's do it. Like, let's try it. Wow. Like,
and another point on that is trainers, gym owners, remember what Zach just said, because your world will be different when we go back. Because Zach just realized that some of the stuff that you're doing, or maybe he doesn't need you as much, or you need to engage more, you need to add more value, okay? Because Zach now is sitting there saying, wait, I you know what? You're not giving me enough here. I could do this. A little bit of this on my own. I could do this. I could do that. Because what's going to happen now too is, if this thing lasts 2 months, you're going to see a lot of the gyms from the bottom. They're going to be gone. Mm-hmm. Okay, and the cream's going to rise to the top, right? And our world is going to be different when we go back. And you better be prepared for it.
I know we have a little bit of time left, but I wanted to ask this: what do you think this does for group fitness? Right, that was kind of having this moment, and maybe that moment was waning. I'm not sure, but now, are people, even after this subsides, however long it takes, are they going to want to be back in that environment? Now, I don't think so right away. I certainly wouldn't. But what does that do for those gyms or those health clubs that do that?
I still think they're going to be fine eventually. You're right. I think people are going to get a little freaked out, going to want a little more room in those classes. Yeah. But I still think, you know, we're going to be hungry for that engagement. As consumers, we're going to want that engagement. We're going to want somebody that's taking care of us, that's being there for us. And that is, you know, like Don said, you know, with earlier, you know, go text those people, get on the phone with them, do a little bit more for them. People are going to want that. They're going to come out of this wanting a little bit more. So you're right. I think, yeah, they're not going to want to crowd into a group. They're going to be like, wait a minute, this is a little weird right now. It's going to take some time to get back. I think we're going to be back fine with that. But yeah. I think people will realize that, you know, sometimes they might not need some of that, but they're still going to want that engagement. They're still going to want to go to those places.
What do you think, Don?
I agree. I just think that, you know, I want to see the quality of these group classes improve. So, you know, unfortunately, I think everyone's going to it's like going to bars. Like, people aren't going to stop going to bars. Like, there's just certain environments. I mean, even with all this shit going down right now, look at the beaches of Florida or look at some of the parks of New York City a week ago. Like, when everyone's told to stay quarantined, to be quarantined, everyone's kind of out having, it's like a party. Like, what happened in Miami the other day was disgusting. There was something like 2,000 boats out, like, in this huge party where, like, Coast Guard couldn't even interrupt it. So, like people are just... You know, people are going to do what they want when they want. You know, I mean, this is, for a lot of people, they understand the severity of this. And for other people, like spring breakers, like, They were still down in Miami partying. I had a friend of mine send me a picture from one of the pools, and I was like, are you kidding me? That's going on now? It was a full-blown party going on. So, you know, for me to turn around and say or disagree with Anthony, that would be wrong. I agree with him 100%. I think now we have to start focusing on cleanliness and preparing for situations like this a little bit more.
All right. Well, we got about less than a minute, so we'll have to do a sign-off. Anthony, where can people find you, and where can they find your podcast?
Strength Coach Podcast. You can go to strengthcoachpodcast.com. That'll just direct you to my site, continuefit.com. And that's where you can find, you know, you can get my book and you can get the podcast and Strength Coach TV. And all my resources are at continuefit.com.
Cool. We at Don Saladino.
At Z Raz. Anthony, I love you, man. Thank you.
Thank you, Anthony.
Don. It's great to meet you. I appreciate it, Zach. I really appreciate it.
Take care, guys.